Hello children, once again welcome to our physics class. See, in the previous session we had discussed about surface tension and also the applications of surface tension. We also discussed about the expression for surface energy. So surface energy is numerically equal to surface tension, but conceptually both are different concepts. Today we are going to discuss a new derivation based on the surface tension. That is, we need to find out an expression for excess pressure inside a drop. Excess pressure inside a drop. So what do you mean by a drop? And why does liquids always tend to assume a spherical drop? That means why the shape of drop is spherical. Okay, so it is due to surface tension. The molecules near the surface of the drop experiences a resultant pull inwards due to surface tension. So because of this inward pull, the pressure inside the liquid is greater than the outside. And due to surface tension, the liquid surface always tend to have a minimum surface area, isn't it? And for a given volume, a sphere has a minimum surface area. Okay, so for a given volume, a sphere has a minimum surface area. So hence, liquids tend to assume a spherical shape. Small drops and bubbles of the liquid assume spherical shape, because when it assumes a spherical shape, area is minimum. On the other hand, for bigger drops, the effect of gravity predominates over the surface tension and the drop gets flattened. So smaller drops and small bubbles always tend to assume a spherical shape because of surface tension, and the pressure inside the drop is greater than the pressure outside the drop. So there is always a pressure difference between inside and outside the drop. So here we have considered one such drop. So this is a drop. It is spherical in shape. And why does liquid drop tend to assume a spherical shape? Due to surface tension. And for a given volume, the minimum area, surface area, is possible for a spherical shape. Okay, so we have considered one such liquid drop, and let R be the radius of this drop. Let Pi be the pressure inside the drop, and Po be the pressure outside the drop. And I have already told you, pressure inside the drop is greater than the pressure outside the drop. That is, Pi will be greater than Po. Okay. So due to this pressure difference, the drop tends to expand because the pressure inside the drop is greater. So this high pressure inside the drop tends to expand this liquid drop. So as a result, the liquid drop expands, and it is expanded by a small radius, that is delta R. So delta R is the amount through which the liquid drop has been expanded. So the area of the liquid drop also increases by a small amount under this pressure difference. Okay, so what is the force acting on the surface of the drop? So here the area of the drop has been increased, so some work is said to be done here. A force has been exerted on this liquid drop due to this pressure difference. So what is the outward force of acting on the drop? So we know that we had already studied one equation. Force is equal to pressure difference into surface area, isn't it? Because pressure is force by area. So force will be equal to pressure into area. So the same equation we are using here. Force is equal to pressure difference into surface area. And here, what is the pressure difference? Pi minus Po. Pi is the greater pressure, Po is the pressure outside the liquid drop, which is less than Pi. So the pressure difference will be Pi minus Po. So Pi minus Po into surface area. You know, the surface area for a sphere is 4 pi r square. So force into pressure difference into surface area. Pi minus Po into 4 pi r square. That is the force. Now what is the work done here? Here the liquid drop has been expanded, so some work is done by this pressure difference. And what is the, some work is done by this force. So what is the work done by this force? So work done is force into displacement. and here the liquid drop has expanded through a small displacement or through a small distance delta r. So the displacement is delta r here. So work done is equal to force into displacement. And what is the force? We had already found out the force, pi minus po into 4 pi r square, it is the force. So substitute here, then you will get pi minus po into 4 pi r square into delta r. So this is the work done. Now, as a result of this work done, area has been increased. So what is the increase in surface area? Increase in surface area is final area minus initial area. So what is the final area? Final area is 4 pi into r plus delta r whole square. Because you know that the area equation is 4 pi r square. But when the liquid drop is expanded, finally the radius has become r plus delta r. So the final radius is 4 pi into r plus delta r whole square. And the initial radius is r. So the initial area will be 4 pi r square. Okay, so increase in surface area will be 4 pi r plus delta r whole square minus 4 pi r square. So here just expand r plus delta r whole square using a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So r plus delta r whole square will be equal to r square plus 2r delta r plus delta r square. So you will get 4 pi into r square plus 2r delta r plus delta r square minus 4 pi r square. Then you can remove this bracket. So when you remove this bracket, you will get 4 pi r square here. Here we have minus 4 pi r square. So it will be cancelled. Then what is left? Here again, multiply 4 pi with this term. So you will get 4 pi into 2r delta r will be 4 into 2, 8. 8 pi r delta r. 8 pi r delta r. Plus one more term will be here, that is 4 pi delta r square. Here we can neglect the term containing delta r square or delta r. So you may have a doubt, why don't we neglect this term? Because this term also contains delta r. But there is a difference. This term contains both r and delta r. This term contains only delta r. So we can neglect those terms which contains only delta r. Since delta r is very, 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 very small compared to other terms. So we can neglect this term and we are left with only this term. And the final expression will be 4 pi into 2r delta r, that is 8 pi r delta r. So this is the increase in surface area of the drop. Now, just find out an expression for work done. Again, we have already found out an expression for work done. See, this is one expression for work done. Pi minus PO into 4 pi r square delta r. This is an expression for work done. Okay, so there is another expression for work done in terms of surface tension. What is that? Work done is equal to increase in surface area into surface tension. We had already discussed this relation for work done in our previous class. So just go through that class. So the work done is equal to increase in surface area into surface tension. That is W is equal to, what is increase in surface area? This is the increase in surface area, 8 pi r delta r into surface tension. That is S. So when we look at equation 1 and equation 2, we can understand both are expressions of work done. So we can equate these two expressions. So just equate these two expressions. So you will get pi minus po into 4 pi r square delta r equal to 8 pi r delta r into s. And here we can cancel the common terms delta r, pi, pi, r, 1 r from this r square, then 4, 2s are 8. So we are left with pi minus po into r equal to 2s. And finally, you will get pi minus po equal to 2s by r. So this is the expression for the pressure difference in the liquid drop, or this is also the expression for the excess pressure inside the liquid drop. Because pi minus po is the pressure difference, which is equal to the excess pressure inside the liquid drop. This excess pressure inside the liquid drop is responsible for the expansion of that liquid drop. Okay, so this is the case of the pressure difference in a bubble, drop. Then we can find out the pressure difference for a bubble. So what is the difference in the case of a bubble? A bubble has two surfaces. So just multiply this expression with 2. You will get the expression for bubble. So Pi minus Po is equal to 2 into 2s by r. That is Pi minus Po equal to 4s by r. So 4s by r is the expression for pressure difference for a bubble, and 2s by r is the expression for pressure difference for a liquid drop. So this is excess pressure inside a drop and inside a bubble. So don't get confused between these two expressions. Practice this derivation. Be thorough. Okay.